Today, I want to go over some basics to get you started using Baserow. So this is a point we have stopped in the last video. We had Baserow up and running and we were greeted by the first time registration form for the admin. So I have pre-filled all my form fields here and now I will just hit sign up. And now we are greeted by an assistant that will help us to set up our first workspace in Baserow. I will just pick marketing here. You can pick whatever you like and hit continue. The survey I will just skip for now. I will just name this one marketing and continue. On the next screen, I can just invite some collaborators. I will also skip this one for now. And here I will just create my first database for this workspace and name this one campaigns and continue. And now the assistant asks me what I want to track and I will just select campaigns just for this example and hit continue. And now Baserow is creating the database for me. So just to give you an overview, I will quickly head to the Baserow dashboard here. This is a marketing workspace we have just created, and as part of the workspace, here is the first database that I named campaigns in the assistant. And the workspace is basically the organizational unit that holds everything together. In the workspace, you manage members of your team, and you can have different databases, and within the databases, there are the different tables. So the workspace is the overarching container. When we go to the context menu here and hit members, you can see there's just one member in here right now, and we can easily invite members just by hitting invite member, put in the email address and drop an optional message. And over here you can set the permissions. So you can see you have the admin role, you have the member role. And for example, you could also select a commenter role for somebody who can view the data and make annotations, but is not able to change it. As you can see, there are more permissions over here that have this little lock on the side. If you need more granular permissions for your use case, that's something you can get, of course, but this will require the premium subscription from Baserow. So now let's have a look at the database we have created with the assistant. So we hit campaign here, which is the database name, and here we have the campaigns table. And this contains one field right now, the name of the campaign. So let's create a new table in our database. I can hit create table over here, and I want to import some data. So I will just quickly go over to mockaroo.com and generate some sample data. So I will just get rid of the ID field here, and I also don't need the IP address. And for now, I will limit this to 200 entries, and I go to generate data and just save it to my computer. And now back in Baserow, I can import the data. I will name the table contacts, and here I will just go for import a CSV file and choose my file over here. Now you can see Baserow will basically automatically detect everything from the CSV file. So the column separator is set to auto detect. Here is the character encoding in case you need it. And it already recognized the first row as header. And here we have a preview of our datasets. And now we can just hit add table and import our data. Now that the data is imported, we can have a look at our table. As you can see, the fields and columns are all as expected. When it comes to importing data into Baserow in general, Baserow makes it very easy and very painless to get datasets into it. On an existing table, we can just hit the three dots and select import file. Import a CSV file, and just for showing you, I would just pick the file we have just imported. As you can see, when I import data into an existing table, I get an additional part in the import dialog, which is the field mapping over here. And this will basically eliminate the need to have perfectly prepared data tables for import. Because what you can do here is you can map the columns in the file to the columns you have in your table. So for example, I could just say, okay, we just skip the first name, and you can see in the preview, the first name is empty. And what I could just do is to map the last name column to the first name column in our file. So this makes it very easy to work with data you already have in spreadsheets or other databases. And when we hit import here now, the data sets will be appended to the existing table. And as you can see here, from line number 200, we have our second import where I have switched the fields and left the last name empty. Now let's quickly talk about the field types in Baserow. When you hit the little arrow next to the field name and you go to edit field, you can change the field type. So for example, when we do this at the email field and search for email here, now we make this field of type email. And what this will do is it will link the email address here. And when you click on it, it will open up your default email program and start sending a message to this contact. For the gender field, it makes sense to have this single select field. So we can just go to the arrow, hit edit field and search for single select. And you can see Baserow is pretty smart about this. It already detected all unique values we have in this column and made an option out of every entry. We could adjust colors or names if we want to, or add other options that are not in the table yet and just hit save. And you can see we have our select fields here now, and this is very easy and comfortable to change. Adding columns is also very simple. You can just hit the plus over here and it will prompt you for a field type. So for example, we can select rating, and here you can select the style the ratings should be and the color and what maximum count you want in it. So I can just give this one 4 stars, give this one 5 stars, and now we have a rating column. Another way to add columns is to go to this context menu, and here you can decide if you want to insert a column left or right. And of course, you can just move columns around as you like. When you want to work with single data sets, you can expand the data set by clicking at the front. And here you can see you have the individual fields. You can just change them as you like. And Baserow will automatically keep track of the changes. So you will always see on the right hand side here what was changed, what was the previous value, and who changed it. And of course, with the arrow navigation here, you can just go to the next entries if you want to. Another useful column in Baserow, for example, is when we just go to the right here and name this one update and search for last. And here we have a last modified field and we just created. And this will automatically keep track when the last change happened. So let me just include the time. And here you can see that the fields up here we just changed. So there's a different timestamp than below here. As we talk about changing data, you can of course delete rows. And Baserow is very forgiving about data deletion. So as you can see, when I delete a row, I can quickly restore it with one button click. And there's also a trash for the database. So I can just click here, and here you can see I just deleted 4 entries from the contacts, and I can just restore them and they are back in my database. So the easiest way to get started with Baserow is to play a little bit around and check out the different field types and what you can do with it and how you can manipulate data. Another great resource for learning Baserow is just to create a new database and select from template. For example, I could just go here to product management and maybe select the user feedback template. And you can see you get a little preview here, and that's also functional. So you can click on the data sets. And when you are interested in trying this out, you can just say use this template, and Baserow will start importing the template. And now here we have our user feedback database. As you can see, this database is a little bit more complex, and this also introduces connected tables, which makes Baserow really powerful, because over here on this column, you can see this little connection icon, and this user is connected to the feedbacks over here, and I can just hit here, and here I can see the feedback that is connected to this specific user. Especially when it comes to connected tables in Baserow, that's actually Baserow's superpower, because when you connect tables with each other, you can create really powerful applications. Talking about table connections will be for another video. So for now, I hope you find this video helpful, and please try out some of the different templates within Baserow, because this will give you a good overview what you can do with it and how you can use it for your own business.